2023年中国加州经贸论坛于5月22日在洛杉矶成功举行。本次论坛是新冠疫情后的首次重启。该主题论坛是中国省与美国加州贸易投资合作联合工作组框架下的年度经贸活动，旨在促进加州与中国相关省市的贸易投资合作。自2016年起，论坛已成功连续举办四届，围绕清洁技术、电子商务、农业、基础设施、创新合作等专题进行了讨论，共吸引双方政商界人士1600余人与会。2023年中国加州经贸论坛的主办方为中国驻洛杉矶总领馆、中国机电产品进出口商会和湾区委员会，主宾省为江苏省。中国驻洛杉矶总领事郭少春等致开幕词，加州副州长康一莲、江苏省副省长方伟、洛杉矶副市长布罗马吉等作主旨演讲。来自中国有关省和加州的约400名政界、工商界及学界代表出席活动。本届论坛分设三个分论坛，分别聚焦清洁技术、电子商务及双边直接投资机遇主题。论坛午餐会为中国国际进口博览会推介会。
今天的这个论坛，我觉得对于促进中国和加州之间的经贸联系、人文往来、文化交流，都应该具有非常重要的意义。江苏省对这次的这个论坛是高度重视的，大家呢彼此呢对于未来的更好的、更多的互利双赢合作充满了期待。
The relationship between China and the Port of Los Angeles continues to thrive. In 2022, 57% of our business went to and from China. That's the highest percentage ever between our two locations and countries. Trade with each. That growing business in North, Central, and South China is what we work together on every single day. This also means a lot of jobs, both here in California as well as in China's many sectors that we trade with. Manufacturing is very important to us, as are the necessary agriculture products that go back to China.Just a tremendous amount of work with our friends across all ports on the eastern seaboard.
Well, you know, California has been the world leader in responding to climate change through technology, investment, invention, innovation. China, too, has been incredibly aggressive about solving the problem. And it is the problem that's facing the whole world, and we're seeing the effects of it.In major weather events that are occurring, sea level rise, floods, drought, heat, fires. And so this is the challenge is upon us. And it only makes sense that the leaders in the world who are addressing the problem should do it together. And so we're looking to have continued cooperation with China and California to address this threat to the future of the world, our children.